forever committed to you. Forever committed to you. God says, I'm gonna be right there. No matter what your life is, I'm gonna be by your side. Said, I'm gonna be by your side. I'm gonna be by your side. God says, I'm gonna be by your side. When you're crying, I'm right by your side. In the midst of your pain, I'm right by your side. Even when you sin, I'm right by your side.
It's good for us to be here one more time. We give God thanks and praise for waking us up this morning for another wake up for the word. And so we have reached that time in the morning where we come together and we give this time specifically to praying concerning the platform and all that God has in store for us. So I invite us at this time to adopt the attitude of prayer as we go into a season of prayer. God bless you.
God bless you, Reverend Mullins. Good morning, Reverend Choir. Father God, as we come before you this morning, Lord God, we are reminded of your word, Lord God. Your word says in 2 Chronicles 7:14, if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves, pray, seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, then you will hear from heaven. You'll forgive us our sins and you'll heal our land. Father God, collectively we are on this platform seeking you daily, Father God, for purpose, for intent, but most of all, Lord God, to be obedient servants to you. And this morning, Lord God, in ways we may have walked out of your will, I ask, Holy Spirit, that you bring us right back. When you said you will forgive us our sins, Father God, we accept your forgiveness, and Father God, may we also be a forgiving people. You promised that you will heal our land, and this platform is, we'll call it our land this morning. This is where we connect. This is where we meet. This is where we fellowship. And so, Father God, I come against every attack of the enemy on this platform. I know, Father God, that we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of darkness and heavenly places. And so, Father God, we need to seek you to cover this place. So we plead the blood of Jesus over it. Everything and every person on this platform, Father God. We will gather here this morning, Lord God, to seek you, Father God. Your word says, you are a rewarder of those who diligently seek you. And Father God, Belize need healing, Jamaica need healing, the whole entire world need healing this morning. And Father God, you are well aware of what happens within these territories and these lands. And Father God, we are asking right now, Father God, that each of us have someone who is leading us. So we're asking, Lord God, that the leaders in whatever position they are, Lord God, will seek you wholeheartedly, Lord God, because things flow from the top and then to the bottom. And we are trusting you this morning, Lord God, that the leaders in governmental authority within the churches, Father God, that we will be in one accord, Lord God. I pray this morning, Lord God, that you, Holy Spirit, will be the driving force within this platform, Father God. We will not be distracted. We will not be deterred. We will hear you. We will seek you, and we will obey your instructions to us, Father God. I pray this morning, Father God, for unity, Lord God. When the apostles were in the upper room, they were all in unity, in one accord, and things happened. And so, Father God, may we be in one accord in spirit, mind, and body, Lord God, as you direct us, Father God. As your children, Lord God, may we be obedient vessels, Lord God. May we, Lord God, be intentional in seeking you wholeheartedly. Because there were words, when you seek me, you will find me. When you seek me with all your heart, and this, Lord God, may our hearts be connected physically and spiritually to hear you this morning, Lord God. May we put aside everything, Lord God, the sin that so easily beset us, Lord God, we ask that we put them aside. And Holy Spirit, I'm crying out to you this morning that you will be in total control, Father God. Each of us this morning will put aside our own self, that we'll be able to hear you, that you will lead us, Father God. And I pray, Father God, that unity with you in one accord, Father God, there's nothing we cannot do. And so, Father God, I am thankful for this platform. I'm thankful for everyone on this platform. And Father God, every day we learn, every day we grow. But I'm trusting you, Lord God, that this platform will not be to glorify me nor a man, but to glorify you, Almighty God, because it was you who gave this vision. And as we continue on this platform, Lord God, the nations of the world will hear about Jesus because a few people decided to be obedient. And Father God, I pray this hour, Lord God, I blanket our families, Lord God, our children this morning, Father God, because when the enemy cannot touch us, he will go to those closest to us. And so, Father God, I come against every attack of the enemy on us personally, individually, collectively, and as the world. I pray, God, that your people, in whatever sphere of influence they are, Lord God, will hear your word, they will obey your word, but most of all, Lord God, they will live out your word, that they will be the living epistles. And so, Father God, I give you back this platform. I give you back everything on this platform. And I'm trusting you, Lord God, with all my heart, that nothing will derail your purpose for us this morning. I give you the honor, the glory, and the praise in Jesus Christ's most wonderful, precious name I pray. Amen.
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 Amen. Almighty God, once again, a group of individuals that constitute this platform, Almighty God, being made up of mere men and women, prone to wander, prone to leave the God they love and the God of love. Men and women who are faced with challenges of their sorts. Men and women who have to encounter difficulties, who have to deal with issues and matters that can be very thorny and can be very difficult at times. We commit them to you. We pray, dear God, that you will meet every issue, every obstacle at the point of impact, the point of discouragement, the point of, as it were, what next? Lord, this platform, dear God, is a platform that has been raised up by you to help others to stand firm in the faith, to guide others as they navigate life's journey, be able to share your matchless grace with others, and to point others to your saving grace. So we ask you, Father, that day by day, moment by moment, you will deal with every situation for each and every one. We want to thank you for each and every one gathered here this morning. We know them by name, know them by nature, and you know, dear God, the intensity of their hearts and the commitment they have to this platform. So we ask, dear God, that you will tabernacle with them, that you will strengthen them, that whatever issues that might they might be facing today, that you will just be there as a buffer, be there as a guard, be there as one who will deal with it for them. Because your word reminds us all that you will never leave us nor forsake us, that you are the same God yesterday, today, and forever, and that same power that rose Jesus Christ from the dead is able to keep and to protect even today. So we commit this platform to your hands and to your care, and ask for your continued guidance and leading. For Christ's sake, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. I want to encourage us to keep the prayers flowing. We do have some time left before the official start time.
Lord, we give you the glory. Lord, we give you the praise. Lord, we honor you. We thank you for who you are. We thank you that you're a God who has never failed us. And despite what is happening around us, we give you all the glory and all the praise. We thank you for this medium that you have provided that has encouraged our lives, that has strengthened our walk with you, just a closer walk with you. That's all we ask for. And we thank you, Lord, that you have provided this way. Lord, we ask that you just continue to strengthen us and that we will continue to be encouraged and we will continue to tell others about how great you are. And that we will continue to cover this platform, that no weapon that form against it will prosper, and that the word will be spread and others will come to know you through this medium. We thank you for all the pastors that are on this platform, and that you will just continue to cover them under your blood. We give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen.
Well, we still have some more time before the official start time. We can continue the prayers.
Shall we bless the Lord?
God is good.
Praise God. Good morning, everyone.
Morning.
Good morning. Most righteous, eternal Father and our God, Lord, we come before your holy presence, mighty God. It's nothing good that we have done to deserve your goodness, but because of your grace and mercy, Father God, we humble bow before you, Lord and mighty God. Wherever we have sinned and come short of your glory, Lord, we repent, O God. Create in us a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within us. Father God, do not take your Holy Spirit from us, mighty God. Father God, we ask that you purge us and cleanse us from every unrighteousness, mighty God, so that your holy presence, O God, will be within us, mighty God. Father God, we can't do without you, not even for a second, Father. And mighty God, we come before your presence, humble ourselves before you, mighty God. We humble ourselves before you, Lord, in adoration, Father. Mighty God, we also want to give you thanks and praise for yet another day, mighty God, a day we have never seen before, mighty God. Father God, we humble ourselves, O God, before you, mighty God, to tell you thanks for what you have done done and is doing for us, mighty God, and what you'll continue to do. Great is your faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies we see. So we give you thanks and praise for new mercies, mighty God. Thank you, Heavenly Father, Father God, for what you have been doing for us, oh God. Father God, you have kept us through the night, oh God, from the snare of the fallen, from the noise and pestilence. Oh God, you have kept us, oh God. So many things could have happened to us, oh God. Indeed, you are awesome and worthy to be praised, mighty God. So we give you thanks, Heavenly Father. Father God, we bless your name because you are God and there is none like you. Great is your faithfulness, Father. Lord, we praise you and we magnify your holy, precious name. You alone are holy. You alone are righteous. You alone are sweet. You are awesome and worthy to be praised. Omnipotent God, we lift up your name this morning. Omniscient God, we praise you. Hallelujah, mighty God. Omnipresent God, we worship you, mighty God. We thank you for yet another day, mighty God. Father God, as we come before your presence, oh God, for wake up to the word, I pray, almighty God, you may bless this platform, mighty God. You may cover each and every person that comes on this platform, mighty God, morning after morning, mighty God. Help us, oh God, to be doers of your word, not just to hear your word, mighty God. Oh God, help us, oh God, to listen to your word, to feast upon your words, to do your words, mighty God, to be attentive to your words, mighty God. Father God, help us, oh God, to know that thy word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. Mighty God, we bless your name this morning because you are the Most High God. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Mighty God, your words declare the Lord thy God in the midst of these mighty. And so we thank you for your words, mighty God. Father God, bless each and every person that is on this platform this morning and those, oh God, who are coming, Lord Jesus. Lord, we lift up your name to give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory. Father God, we magnify you because you are God and God alone. Lord, we thank you for your many blessings, the gift of life, for your grace and mercies yet another time. Lord, we thank you for your words. We thank you, Lord, for each and every person that will be participating this morning. Those will be interceding, those will be taking, will be doing the word, oh God. Lord God, will be proclaiming the word to let us understand more about the word. Those will be praying for others, Lord. Those who, the person will be doing the moderating, whatever person, whatever the person will be doing to take part, oh God, in this morning's this morning's program, Lord Jesus, we pray, Lord, you'll cover them, Jesus. Father God, I pray, Jesus, that you'll cover us under your blood. Help us, oh God, to be in one accord, mighty God. Unity is strength. Help us, oh God, to be our brother's keeper, mighty God. Father God, we put Jamaica in your hands, oh God. Jamaica is in trouble, Lord God. So many bloodshed is happening, mighty God. So many things are happening in Jamaica, mighty God. Father God, we pray, Jesus, that you'll touch the young people, oh God. You may touch the gunmen, mighty God. Father God, you may touch the ones who are doing wickedness, oh God, and they'll turn, mighty God. Father God, in your words, you say, my people are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways. Then we'll hear from heaven and you'll heal the land. Father God, Jamaica needs healing, Father. I pray, God, for the praying ones that you'll strengthen them, Lord. That we'll continue to pray and live a life that is pleasing to you, Lord. That we'll shine our light, mighty God. Your word said in St. Matthew chapter 5, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Hallelujah to your holy name. Father God, we bless in him and we give you all the praise. We bless in him and we give you all the honor. And we thank you for your words, because without your words, we can't make it. Without your words, it gives us strength. It gives us healing. It gives us victory. It gives us comfort. And so, Father, we thank you for your words. We bless your holy name and we give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory. And whatever we feel of asking, a mighty God, do not fail to grant it unto us. In Jesus Christ's holy name, I pray. Amen.
So at this time, we're going to invite our sister Vinette Hilton to go ahead and begin moderating today's program.
Morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. God is good, and all the time, God is good. We want to thank the dear Lord for waking up this morning and close us in our right mind. We want to thank him for his mercy and for his grace towards us. And as we come on this platform this morning, I want to welcome each and everyone. We want to welcome Pastor King. We want to welcome Reverend Mark Mullin, Reverend Martha Mullins, Pastor Philippa, Apostle King, Pastor Scarlett, and Pastor Masado, and all the pastors on this platform, and all those wonderful saints of God that is on this platform this morning. We greet you in the mighty name of Jesus. And we come, wake up with the word, filled with spiritual food for the journey. I ask that the dear Lord will continue to guide us as we go day by day, and to take this word that's going on this platform. It is a good thing to be on this platform because you have changed many lives. And for that reason, we need to continue with this thing. And I hope that God will continue to strengthen us as we go day by day. And I'm asking Sister Edgar to read the morning's, to open the morning prayer for me this morning. Praise the Lord. Is Sister Edgar here?
Yes, I am. Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. We worship and adore your name, God. We lift you up. You're a mighty God. We want to thank you, God, for your love. We want to thank you, God, for dying for us, for giving us this opportunity that we can come to you in this fashion. Father God, as we proceed further this morning, Lord, we pray for your direction. We pray for your leading. God, without you, we can do nothing. And so we acknowledge, Lord, our need of you this morning. We pray, God, that as your word is read and as the navigator speak, Lord, we pray that you give us receptive hearts. God, help us not just to be hearers of your word, but doer of your word. God, we pray that you will anoint the one who is going to be navigating this morning. God, we pray that you will give him a word, Lord, for us, God. Father God, the one who will be interceding, God, we pray that you will bless her in a mighty way. God, we pray that as we continue, Lord, that we will recognize, Lord, that your word is a lamp unto our feet. And God, that we need, Lord, to know your word, especially in this time. Father God, we pray that you will bless everything that is said and done this morning. And you will strengthen heart, you will comfort heart, God. Father, I pray that you will save this morning those who need to be saved. And Father, help us to continue to just serve you, to have a desire, Lord, to be like you and to live a life that is pleasing to you. We give you all the glory and honor even now through your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
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 Amen. Lord, this morning is Thankful Thursday, and I'm asking Sister Judith King to come Henry. With her this
Judith morning. Henry.
Judith, praise God. Sorry for the confirmation.
All right, Sister Vinette, I'm not seeing her online. We may proceed until she comes on.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. I want to ask Sister Darcy Grant is there.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Sister Darcy, good morning. Lesson.
Good morning.
Isaiah 30:27-33.
That's Isaiah 30:27-33.
Yes.
Give me a minute, please.
Okay.
Reading from the King James Version, Isaiah 27 to 33. Yes, ma'am. Behold, the name of the Lord cometh from far, burning with his anger, and the burden thereof is heavy. His lips are full of indignation, and his tongue as a devouring fire, and his breath as an overflowing stream shall reach to the midst of the neck, to stiff the nation with the sieve of vanity, and there shall be bridle in the jaws of the people, causing them to hear. He shall have a song as in the night, when a holy solemnity is kept, and gladness of heart, as when one goeth with a pipe to come into the mountain of the Lord, to the mighty one of Israel. And the Lord shall cause his glorious voice to be heard, and shall shew the lightning down of his arm with the ignition of his anger, and with the flame of devouring fire, with the scattering of tempest and hailstone. For though the voice of the Lord shall the Assyrians be beaten down with smooth with a rod, and in every place where the grounded staff shall pass, which the Lord shall lay upon it, it shall be with the tabret and the harps, and in the battles of the shaking with be fighting with them. 33 and last. To the tablet in the ordering of the old, yea, for the king is king, it is prepared. He had made it deep and large. The pipe thereof is fire and much wood. The breath of the Lord, like a steam of brimstone, doeth kindle it. Here end the portion of God's holy word. We honor it by saying, thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
At this time, you know, we have a word to come to us, and our navigator will be our very own Pastor Paul King. Welcome you as you come to give the word this morning, as you navigate the word. I hope that we will take this word that we have and lodge it in our heart, and we go and rejoice in with this word. Pastor Paul King.
Good morning, Pastor Remnant Core. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, my brother, Reverend Mark Mullins, and Reverend Sina Mullins. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Surely it is a pleasure to be on this morning again to share in this navigation. God bless you also, Reverend Pastor Philippia Apolloni. I was looking for my friend, but I don't see her this morning. That is Pastor Ewan. God bless you. Elder Cohen, God bless you. Also, surely you have been also a blessing to me. God bless you also, Apostle Delroy Simit. Apostle Simit, God bless you. Good to have you on this morning. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God, my brother from another mother. Glory be to God. We bless God also for Pastor Mesado. She was my lecturer. I'm going to a leadership class. God bless you, Reverend Mesado. There are some things that you said to us that is really stuck in my mind, and I keep on holding on to them. I'm looking for Reverend Scarlett, but if he's on another device, God bless you, sir. And to all the Remnant Core and all the Eagles that are here with us this morning, God bless you. And for persons from different churches, God bless you also. We just thank God for the way that he's working with us and through us. I want to say to us this morning, glory to God, as we continue on this path, wake up for the word, and fill with spiritual food for the journey, that the enemy is mad with us. Take that to the bank. You know, he's mad with us. Amen. Do you believe that he is going to allow us to wake up for the word every morning and do not put up a fight? But God wants us to stay focused.
Amen.
And so that purpose will be fulfilled. We are purpose driven. I heard Reverend Mullins say that we are purpose driven. We are the remnant. We are the eagle, and we are saints of God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. So when the enemy put up a fight. God said, I will raise up a standard against him. Glory be to God. And this morning, I want to tell you that there's a standard that is raised up against the enemy, and the enemy is trying to put up a fight. But our God is able to do far exceedingly abundantly than we can even imagine. The previous verses tells us that God warned, there's a warning that was given unto us. Do not look to Egypt or other nations. They cannot help you. They cannot help you. Glory be to God. Not even your own can help you. It takes God to help you. That's why David said, I will look to the hills from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from God. Glory be to God. So they were one. Do not form an alliance with other nations. Remember, you belongs to God. And if you belongs to God, God will give you everything that you need as long as you stay in his perfect will. When we were reminded yesterday that when we removed our idols and turned to God, then healing will take place. Glory be to God. You cannot have idols and experience healing. The enemy will set you up and let it be seemingly that you are having healing, but it's a temporal one. But we are reminded through Chronicles 7 and 14 says, if my people that is called by my name will just humble themselves and turn and seek my face, then I will hear from heaven and I will what? Heal their land. So healing take place when we put away our idols. So therefore this morning, as I go through the text that is provided this morning, it is Isaiah 30, 27 to 33. Very wonderful chapter. And what pumped out to me this morning as I read the text, it says, put your trust in God. The battle belongs to him. Glory be to God. We somebody who just open their mic and give God a praise.
Hallelujah.
Put your trust in God.
Hallelujah.
The battle belongs.
Hallelujah. To hallelujah.
Give
him
a glorious praise this morning.
Hallelujah, Lord. You're worthy.
Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We looked at verse 27. It says, behold, the name of God. Of God, that is Yahweh, come from afar with burning anger and with rising smoke. His lips are full of indignation, his tongue is a devouring fire, and his breath is an overflowing stream that reach even to the neck to sift the nation with the seeds of worthlessness, and a bridle that caused an arrow to be in his jaw. And then we look at the fact that when you look at it, it says, you will have a song in the night when a holy feast is kept, and gladness of heart, as when one goes with a pipe to come to the mountain of Yahweh, to the rock of Israel. That is Isaiah 30 and verse 29. And the Lord will cause his glorious voice to heard and show the descendant the descending blow of his arms in indignation of his anger. God is angry with this nation. God is angry with the people that are coming against his people. The flame of a devouring fire with crashing of ton of storm. And then we looked at it, it says, and tempest and hailstone, Isaiah 30 and verse 30, as we go along. For through the voice of God, will Assyrian be broken in pieces, who smote with a rod, or whom he smote with a rod. Isaiah 30 and verse 31. We're coming down very nicely. And the stroke of the appointed staff that God will lay on him will be tambourines and harp, and he will fight with them in battle and shaking. Isaiah 30 and verse 32. As we go along, a far tuppet is prepared of old. Yes, it made ready for the king that he has made deep and large. It is piled fire and much wood. The breath of Yah of God, like a stream of brimstone, kindled. And so we see that in
Isaiah 30 and verse 33. Now, as we looked at this very carefully, we see that God uses the Assyrians to be a rudder to correct his people. But do you know that whenever some persons are in control, you give them an inch and they take a mile. Glory yeah. to God. Hallelujah. You give them an inch Jesus. And they take a mile. And so what has happened with Assyria is that God have allowed them to be the rod to correct Israel. But they were doing it far extremely than God want them to. And so because they were very blood hungry and very thirst, they give Israel and Judah the length of the rod, and God I will say to them, stop. God comes with a burn. We see that God comes in anger, in thick smoke. His breath is like an overflowing stream which reached to the neck, to the fifth nation, and in parallel to prepare for a sacrifice and a pile of fire. May I say to you, in verse 33, when we see Topet, it was a place that sacrifice that was already made by the children of Israel. And we see why God have to really awaken Israel to righteousness and know that God is still God and his precepts and his laws still remain. God has never changed. And so what has happened in Topet, a place in Jerusalem, they used to have an era where they offer sacrifice, even the children, they were passed through fire. And Lord tells us that we should not offer our children, hallelujah, to Molech requires the blood of our children. But when we step up of line, we will lose focus and not knowing what God wants us to do and not also know our purpose. We should not offer any human sacrifice or any more sacrifice anymore. And so therefore, when I bring it back to here presently, we must understand that when Jesus Christ died, there was no more sacrifice. Glory be to God. That's why Paul says to us in Romans chapter 12, I beseech you, brethren, by the mercy of God, to present what? Your bodies as a living sacrifice, pure, holy, accept them to God, which is your reasonable service. I hear one songwriter says, you don't have to slay any lamb anymore. You don't have to place the blood over the door. Why? Jesus Christ, the place of the lamb. Glory be to God. Somebody give God a praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Somebody can have to slay any lamb anymore. Hallelujah. We do not have to place any blood over the door. Why? Jesus Christ have taken the place of the lamb. And we looked at it in 27. Now, let us unwrap this thing up now in 27. It says in 27 of the same of the chapter, it said, behold, the name of the Lord comes from afar. Behold, the name of the Lord coming from afar. And we see the anger, it says, come with burning anger in thick rising smoke. His lips are full of indignation, and his tongue is a devouring fire, and his breath is an overthrowing stream that reach even to the neck to sift the nation with a sieve of worthless. Business and bride and a bridle that caused to err be in the jaw of the people. Now, the approach of the name of Yahweh demonstrates that God has that he has come forward vindication to establish his name and reputation. God have a reputation that God have to live by. We as children of God, we have a reputation. We are called to holiness, so we must live holy. Come on. We are called to righteousness, so we must live righteous life. Yes. We are called to be just, and so we got to live, hallelujah. We got to be persons who are justified. justify by faith. So God, our reputation, we saw here, as I said before, the Assyrian, God used him as a rod, glory to God. But they went beyond what God told them to do. Listen to me. When God speaks to us on a specific area, we got to do as God commissioned us to do and don't do otherwise. The moment that we step out of line and begin to do what we believe ought to be done and not in consultation with God, then we are in trouble. And the enemy is laughing at us. When I was going to Tucker Church, one brother said when he was preaching that the greatest enemy of the church is the church. Amen. The greatest enemy of the church is the church. That's why Paul said the fight is within and the fight is without. What the enemy will do to us, he will set us up. Not only he will set us up, but when he set us up, he will laugh at us. But I want to tell us this morning, hallelujah, when God called out the remnant, when God called out the eagle, and God called out the saints, glory be to God, hallelujah. All we got to do is to stay focused, hallelujah. And remember, glory be to God, hallelujah, that we must put our trust in God and he will fight the battle. Oh, somebody give God a praise. Somebody get it right. The enemy, hallelujah, will set us up and the enemy will want to destroy us, but we must put our trust in God. Why? Because the battle belongs to God. Somebody give him a praise in the house. Somebody give him a praise in the house. Somebody give him a praise in the house. God uses Assyria, but Assyrians, they went beyond what God told them to do. And so therefore we saw in Isaiah 10 and verse 6, God said, against a godly nation I've sent him, that is Assyria, against a people of my wrath. I command him to take the spoils and seize plunder and thread them down like the myrrh of the street. Isaiah, that is Isaiah 10 and verse 6. But in Isaiah 10 and verse 12, it says, woe to those who make unjust laws, to those who issue the impressive decree, God comes to make matters right. Come on. God says, when they begin to do this, I comes to make matters right. Hallelujah. For anger combined with thick rising smoke, oh God, hallelujah. We remembered what happened when it comes on to Sodom and Gomorrah. It was God's anger that destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah. Why? Because Sodom and Gomorrah was acting out of God's will. They were practicing sodomism. Not only that, they were practicing homosexual, and also they were lesbian. And so we recognize that even when the angel went down to Sodom and Gomorrah, what has happened is that they wanted the angels and not women. And so therefore we recognize that God destroyed them. Glory to God, the destruction of Gomorrah. Hallelujah. And we also look at the fact that God for devouring fire compare, we recognize that the God that we serve will destroy a nation with fire. The thick rising smoke emphasize the nature of his anger. Ah, God, listen to me. People are saying that we have a good and loving God, but we have a God that gets angry sometimes when his people are not acting and not obeying his will. Amen. God gets very angry. Ah, somebody need to give God a praise. It's a consuming fire. But God, it is a consuming fire whenever people saw rising smoke in the distance, they knew that it was also that something bad is about to happen. weapon that destruction accompanied it. One of my, I love to watch cowboy and Indian show, and one of the things that I see when the Indians are going to go to war, they send up a smoke. Lord of mercy. I want to say to somebody, God is about to fight the battle for somebody. God's amen. About to destroy the world.
Hallelujah.
Truth for you, God. To God. Put your trust in God. The battle belongs to Him. Somebody give Him a praise. What is about to happen to the enemy? And the enemy do not like it. So the enemy is trying his best to bring discouragement. The enemy is trying his best to let you become discouraged and walk away from the work of God. I want to say to you, stay with God. Stay with God. Stay with God. He's about to do something supernatural. Thus we have here, and also the God of Mount Sinai, the God of covenant, God's a God that appears to Moses and Mount Sinai, the in thick smoke, the God of the covenant. He's also the God of the covenant. He's also the greatest deliverer of all time. Can somebody say this morning, Jesus is my deliverer.
Jesus is my
God. Glory to God. And as long as we glory to God, when the enemy comes upon me like a flood, God raise up a standard against him. The weapon that form against you will prosper, because God says he will send angel concern you, because the angel of the Lord encamp it around you. Oh, glory to God. They that are, listen to me, they that are against you, hallelujah, glory to God. God said to tell you that they will come to naught, because they that are with you are more than they that are against you. And if God is first, glory be to God, then who will be against us, hallelujah. I hear somebody saying, all over me, and he's keeping me alive. Jesus is keeping me alive. And so we continue on the part, the God of covenant, and also we see now that God is appearing to exercise wrath. He comes from afar, for he has been standing back. Watch, God is standing back out of this world, allowing events to go forward, but now he can stand no longer. God is standing back afar, but no, God is saying, I'm not going to stand afar any longer. I'm to let these events upon. Why? Because I have a remnant core. I have the eagles. I have a saint of God that need to be protected. Glory to God. When they turn back to me, God says, hallelujah. When they turn back to me, God says, I'm going to fight for them. I'm going to show the enemy that I am still God. Somebody give him a praise this morning.
Hallelujah.
He's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. God says, I am allowed the event to upon. But now he can stand up no longer. Hallelujah. He burns with anger. His lips flow with indignation. His tongue is like a devouring fire. His breath, a wind like a devouring flood that reach even the neck. Somebody give him a praise. Because of the treatment, listen to me, because of the treatment meted out to his people, God is about to do something supernatural. Hallelujah. Oh, somebody give him a praise this morning. To bring depth of feeling for his people, because we have a God that is touched with the feeling of our infirmities. Glory to God. He has come to seize their oppressors in a sea of worthlessness, which will analyze and reveal that they are revealing their worthlessness and filthiness.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. And to them into disaster with a bridle. Lord, we put a bridle and an ass to lead us, but God, because of their own waywardness and their blindness, God put on a bridle on them to lead them into error. Glory be to God. Because when you fall out of God's presence, you are heading down to a road of destruction. Hallelujah. So God says, they are heading down to a way where they are going astray. Hallelujah. They were astray like a wild animal. God says they are still on the, watch this, God says, though the government and the people of today are behaving some ways as if them run things, God says to tell you that he is still in control. Somebody need to no longer, as the rod is anger, See, let me tell you something. God is still in control, and the word of God still stands that the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. Everything belongs to God, and God do what he please. But now, as the anger, they have overstepped the mark, and he will work his will on them. Oh, glory be to God. The idea of the flood of the neck, which is compensating Assyria earlier behavior, we see while stressing the depth may be given an assurance that it will not be like the flood in the same of Noah. Hallelujah, all consuming, while it was severe judgment, it will not be it will not be the final, because the final we're going to see that it's going to take part as it relates to the ending of the chapter. So we understand now, glory to God, that when it comes on to him, glory to God, we saw what God did as it relates to the flood, that the nation that Noah was preaching to, they weren't accepting God. But watch this, God in the dunes of time prepared Noah to build an ark. Oh, glory to God. And God said, get into the ark. I'm about to shut the door because what? Destruction is coming. I'm going to let the flood come up to their neck. They are going to be drowned. But Noah, you are a righteous seed. You are the remnant of this era. You are the eagles and you are the saints of this era. I want you to get into the ark. Amen. And I'm about to shut it. Amen. Oh, glory to God. Amen. I'm about to shut the door. Amen. In the enemy's seat. Because God is telling you this morning, glory be to God, that you are a remnant, that you belongs to him. God's about to shut the door, and when God shut the door, the enemy cannot come in. And so this morning, we must understand that no more that we have a literal ark, but we have the ark of the covenant with God, and that is Jesus Christ himself, and the ark of the covenant. When we become a Christian, we have entered onto that ark of a covenant. Hallelujah. And guess what? When we enter onto that ark of covenant, we are trusting God, and not only that, we are saying, God, fight my battle, Lord of mercy. When we get into the ark, glory to God, God protect us from the natural element, from the water that is about to take over, because God said, I will go to the enemy like a flood. I will go to the enemy, glory to God, to destroy the enemy, hallelujah, with all of these natural elements. And so we keep on going, hallelujah. He said, you will have a song. Glory be to God. I love verse 29. I love verse 29. He said, you will have a song in the night when a holy feast is kept, and gladness of heart, as when one goes with a pipe to come to the mountain of God, to the rock of Israel. Jesus is there, and Jesus the rock I stand. Glory to God. I want to tell somebody this morning that you are going to have a song, because God will destroy the enemy. God will destroy the enemy.
Glory to God.
And you are going to have a song. You are going to have a song that you'll be rejoicing into, because God, hallelujah, will destroy the enemy. Glory to God. Can't you understand that when the enemy is defeated, sometime in church we say, I went to the enemy's camp and I took back what he stole from me. Somebody say, take back your joy, take back your peace, take back your joy, take back your peace, take back your family, take back your sons and your daughters. I went to the enemy's camp, and we begin to sing the song, victory in Jesus. Hallelujah, victory in Jesus. Victory today is mine. I told Satan, get thee behind. Why? Because victory belongs to Jesus. And we keep on going. Hallelujah, glory to God. We keep on going. When God strike, when God, listen to me, when God strike, the enemy cannot recover.
Amen.
Come on. When God strike, the enemy cannot recover. And Assyria never come back to his former position. The enemy, glory to God, may be hostile, and he want to destroy the very works of God, the very works of salvation. You got to tell the enemy, glory to God, that the Lord is my salvation. Of whom shall I be afraid?
Amen.
Even the wicked come up to eat of my flesh. This song that we are singing, it is not for the ungodly, Lord have mercy. It is for the righteous. The song that we sing, the unrighteous cannot sing, I am redeemed.
Glory to God.
The unrighteous cannot say that I was bought with a price. Glory to God. The unrighteous cannot say I want to walk the road that Jesus walked for me. I want to wash my robe in the blood, the sprinkle of the mercy seat. Glory be to God. Yeah. The redeemer of the Lord says, I am redeemed, not with silver and gold. I am redeemed. The blood of Jesus Christ. Glory to God. He placed it on my forehead. He placed it on my heart. He placed it in my hand, he placed it on my feet. Jesus, blood, cover me, cover me, cover me.
Hallelujah.
Jesus, because when I see the blood, Jesus, the word said, when I see the blood, the enemy is afraid of the blood because the enemy knows that the blood, hallelujah, have the power. The enemy knows that the blood have never lose its power.
Never.
To the highest mountain.
Hallelujah.
Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. It runs.
Hallelujah.
I mean, somebody give my praise in the house.
Hallelujah.
Oh, so we watch that as we get down into verse 30. Says, and God will cause his glorious voice to be heard and will show the descendant blow of his arms in indignation of his anger and a flame of defile. Listen to this. And God will cause his glorious voice. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I want to say, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Hallelujah. And lean unto him. Please acknowledge him, and God will bear it apart. Glory be to God. Trust in the Lord forever. For the Lord himself is the rock of our salvation.
Hallelujah.
Salvation. God is the rock. I'm in Isaiah 26 and verse 4. God is a rock of our salvation, and whom God save, God is able to keep.
Amen.
Yes. Somebody bless the name of the name of Jesus. We give you praise this morning. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. And God will cause his glorious voice to be heard and will show the descendant blow of his arm, the indignation of his anger, and the flame of a devouring fire with the crashing of thorn and tempest and hailstone. So we have seen an angry God, hallelujah, raining judgment, but he's warning also his people. For through the voice of God will the Assyrian be broken, what? In pieces, who smote with the rod. God says, enough is enough. Lord have mercy. Amen. Can't you see what is happening today? That the enemy cannot stop. The enemy is basking in his glory. The enemy, hallelujah, is oppressing God's people. The enemy, glory to God, want to destroy God's people. Lord have mercy. And we see what has happened now before. Yes. They come with COVID, and now they are coming with monkeypox. Because today, yesterday, some people were very frightened and alarmed when they watched the news and they heard that the first case of monkeypox in St. James is, there's a case in St. James that is found with monkeypox. Not only that, that they are found with monkeypox, but this person is in isolation. But watch this, as they did it before, they are going to do it again. Because why? They are saying to us that person is in isolation, and the ministry now saying, we are going to do contact tracing.
Come on.
Ah, Lord Jesus.
That person, this is a deception from the pit of hell. They want to shut us again, down again. But tell somebody, no more shut down, Lord of mercy. No more shut down. The church must blend her voice together and make a joyful noise unto the Lord and let the enemy know that we are still alive and come to our neighbor serving God. Fear not, fret not. Why? Because God is with the church.
Amen.
But I watch God as God begin to unfold something, because there are those who form an alliance. God is breaking that alliance when it comes on to the nation. I read yesterday where in the G7 is coming against Russia to say that they need to give back Ukraine their nuclear plant. And they say that they're firing at the nuclear plant. And if that, if that explode, it could put the country and the whole world in devastation. Oh God, but I'm thankful for God. God said, be of good courage, as I was with Joshua and Moses. So I will be with my people. I want to tell you that God knows how to rescue righteous people. God knows how to rescue, glory to God, godly men. When our ways leave God, God will put a cocoon over us and protect us.
Amen.
Listen to me. In all of it, do not lose your praise.
Do
not lose the praise, because all praise and glory are God. Somebody take that 30 seconds. Somebody give him a praise this morning.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you. Much more that I want to say, but I got to close right here. When we begin to praise God, God show up.
Amen.
When our praises please God, God will show up.
Amen.
And not only that, God will fight the battle for you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Give God the credit. And God will establish you.
Hallelujah.
Give God the praise, and God will establish you. Indeed, when we look at the what is happening, glory to God, we say God is fighting for battles. He's shaking the nation. Lord have mercy, hallelujah. Because we see that now that Taiwan is coming against China, and China going against Taiwan. What God is doing today, God is using the enemy to destroy the enemy. So he's trying to set us up in the church, but God is setting them up.
Amen.
And that, not only that, their one is very open, because they are fighting over God's land. And they are fighting for power. But glory be to God, hallelujah. All power and glory and the might belongs to God. Hallelujah. Yes, we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principality. Glory to God and power. But I want to say to the church this morning, put on the whole armor of God. We are about to march around Jericho with our tamari and our
heart. I must come down.
We are about to march around Jericho.
Hallelujah.
Why? Because Jericho wall must come down.
It is not
if they are going to come down, it is that Jericho wall must come down. God, listen to me. God, people must act in order.
Amen.
God, people must act as a calling to God's will.
Amen.
God's people must follow God's instruction.
Amen.
God's people must live as all God wants us to live.
Hallelujah.
We cannot live wayward, and it's hard to fight the battle for us. And our ways, please God, he will fight the battle for us.
Yes.
He will instruct us what to do to destroy, hallelujah, to destroy the very works of the enemy. Because the works of the enemy is at work today. But glory be to God, the church of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And when you do have the Holy Ghost, you have power.
Amen.
And when you have power, greater God, you can say to demons and devils, in the name of Jesus, take up your weapon and flee, because the blood of Jesus is against somebody. Give God a praise. The church is going to burst out in praise. The church is going to burst out in joy. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. So some person is going to have testimony. Stop and let me tell you what the Lord have done for me. Heal my body. He saved my soul. Hallelujah. And he baptized me. The enemy see that it is coming down. Why? Because God said Tophet was already built for the devil. The place of burning fire and brimstone, it was already built for the devil. And God, in the end, when we look at Revelation, the enemy will be bound and he'll be thrown into the fiery furnace. And that will be the final judgment. Lord of mercy. Hallelujah. I want to say to somebody, you come too far to turn back now.
Amen.
Come too far to turn back now.
Yes,
do not
amen.
Look to the enemy. Look to God. Do not look to government. Look to God. Hallelujah. The plan is a four. They come out every four years. They give you all of these care packages and masquerade themselves and let you believe that they have the answer. Jesus is the answer. The world today, glory to God, why the world is in so much turmoil, because the world have not yet trust Jesus, but the remnant core and the eagles and the saints of God, hallelujah, we put our trust in God and say, God,
hallelujah.
Somebody, God, I praise
you. Hallelujah.
In the spiritual realm, he said when Elijah's servant came to him and was worried, when he see a big army, they come. Oh God, they begin to worry. Oh, go to God. But when and the man of God said, God, open your eyes, let him see what is happening. Some of us spiritual eyes, some of us have eyes, but we're not seeing. Some of us have an eye, but we are not seeing what is happening.
Oh,
why? Because
God.
We
got to remove the scales out of their eyes.
And accept the word of God. Yeah. Guess what? We don't become alarmed when it comes down to the word.
Uh-uh.
Oh, glory to God. We don't come alarmed with what is happening today. Because what is happening today must have happened, will happen.
Yes.
But glory be to God. I hear God says, God, tell the remnant, tell wake up for the word that I have prepared a Goshen. I have prepared a Goshen. You might be in Egypt, a part of Egypt, but there's a land that I've prepared, there's a space in your own space that I've provided. It is called your Goshen. And bless what? Glory to God. None of the things that the enemy is trying to bring us up will harm us. Glory to God. Will destroy us. Glory to God. I want to tell you that the enemy will come near, but the enemy cannot touch us unless God.
Hallelujah.
And that is what happened when it comes down to Job. Hallelujah. It was God who gave him permission to do so. He could not touch Job. And so if anything is happening in your life, don't let anybody tell you that you have a curse in your life. If you are living a holy life, glory to God, it's a test. If you are living a holy life, it's a test.
Yes.
If you are living a righteous life, it's a test.
Amen.
And God will not give you more than you can bear. Continue to show the enemy that you are. And glory to God, to use you as a testimony to tell the enemy that you belong to him and you're not full of the devil and the end of this world. Somebody give God a praise in the house.
Trust God.
God is fighting our battle. Just watch it. Be still and know that God is God.
Glory
to God. God bless you. The enemy knows that his time is coming to an end. So there's a Tophet. The Tophet that he created in Jerusalem. God says, whosoever diggeth a pit shall fall in it. Lord have mercy. Hallelujah. What I read this morning, whosoever diggeth a pit, the enemy is about to fall into that pit. Glory to God, because God said,
Tophet
is already prepared for the kings and those who turn your back on God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. If you are going through struggles, remember that the devil ate you. And so, but he cannot stop your blessings. God bless you as you come to worship him. Trust God.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Open your mind and let me hear you worship the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Remember that we can be our worst enemy. Remember that we can be our worst enemy. Hallelujah. We need not to fight against each other. What we need to do is to come together and go to the enemy. One chair put 1,000 to flight, but 2 10,000 to flight. When God, when the church is on fire, when the church is on fire, change must take place.
Amen.
Church is on fire. Our country will change. Hallelujah. But the church is too silent, not knowing that we have a God that is omnipotent. We have a God that is all powerful, and that a God can destroy an army without even your lift a stone.
Amen.
Trust God. Trust God, remnant. Trust God, eagle. Trust God. Hallelujah. Saints of God. Hallelujah. And watch God come through us for us through this battle. The enemy kingdom is about to come down. Babylon is fallen. Glory to God. The angel cries out. Babylon, Babylon is fallen. Glory to God. The system, the political system, the religious system, they must come to naught. Lord have mercy. Glory to God. And the kingdom of God must reign in our hearts. Somebody said, thy kingdom come, let thy will be done.
Amen. I will be done. Surrender to the Holy Spirit.
Trust God. Trust God. Trust God. With that bad report you get from the doctor, trust God. Hallelujah. With what is happening in your spiritual life, trust God. Because you can have a testimony just like Job, for I know that my Redeemer lives. And God will give you double for your trouble.
Hallelujah.
Thank
you, Jesus. Bishop King has reminded us that we must stay with God. Remind us that we must, when we set up the praises, God is, and when God is pleased with our praise, He will show. So let us praise God that the blessing of God may show up upon us. Praise God, what a word. Praise God, my soul is well blessed. And I assure everyone's soul blessed this morning. Praise God. This time we're going to have the prayer for the request, intercessor prayer by Sister Fogo Jones.
Praise God, hallelujah, hallelujah, praise God, Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah.
God.
Jesus, we come to you. Jesus, we come with expectancy, Lord, putting our faith this morning at work. For God, we know that beyond the shadow of a doubt, that you are the healing Jesus.
Yes.
We know, Lord, that you will make a way for your people where there seems to be no way. Lord, many times we feel frustrated and discouraged with what is happening around us. But we know, Lord, who we are and whose we are. And with boldness, we come to you this morning. Psalm 107:20, he sendeth his word and healeth them and delivereth them from their destruction. Lord, when the enemy throw his darts at us, we know we can cry out to you. You are our source. You are all we need in these troublesome times. Oh God, help us not to lose heart. Help us not to lose our faith in you. Help us to walk, God, with our heads held up high, knowing that our God is a deliverer. Father, We put all these prayer requests this morning. Sister Binet Hilton requests prayer for Mount Pleasant in Westmoreland, where somebody got shot and killed last night. Father God, all these destructive weapons coming into our country, killing our people, God, the enemy let loose. But God, you are going to set up a standard against the enemy. So God, we pray for the family this morning as they mourn. And God, only you can take them through that healing process that they need, Lord. God, we pray for our ports, our airport and our seaport, where all these weapons coming in, Lord. We ask that you will intercept them and you will bring justice in the name of Jesus, for you are a just God. We pray for the Westmoreland police and officer who was shot in the neck yesterday. We pray for his family. We pray, God, that you will bring healing to his body in the name of Jesus. We know, God, that when we cry out to you, you hear us.
Lord.
And we know, Lord, because when we ask for prayer, it's because we believe in you and we believe in prayer.
Amen.
And we know that prayer changes things.
Amen.
Oh, God, we cry out to you. Sister Karen Bernard requests prayer for her restaurant, business, and farm. Lord, we pray that you will prosper her business. Give her, Lord, an overflow that she'll be able to take care of her bills and her family in the name of Jesus. Father, Pastor Philippa requests prayer for boldness and wisdom for our children of God. Lord, we are praying daily for our children. We want to see them as mighty warriors for you. God, we want to keep them away from gun and crime and violence. We know, Lord, that these days young people, they are so hard to come to the full knowledge of Jesus Christ and his power. So God, we pray that you will save them. You will give them a heart of repentance. Lord, we pray that they will run to you.
Oh, Lord.
Because they are not too young to serve you. We pray, God, that you will save them at early age before they get mixed up in the world and its pleasure. Oh, God. We are depending on you for our children because, Lord, when we come off the scene, we want to hear, or we want to know before we come off the scene that our children are saved and they are walking with you, Lord. Please give them strength and boldness, Lord, to live a Christian life that when the enemy throw his darts at them, they will stand up like the three Hebrew boys. Oh, God, please hear our prayer today. Sister Pringle, with that pain in her left shoulder, Father God, we pray for a special anointing on her body right now, Lord. A special anointing on our bodies. All those who are feeling aches and pain, we pray, Lord, that you will just anoint us from the crown of our head to the very soul of our feet this morning. And God, we will go rejoicing. We are healed in the name of Jesus. Because the enemy will not have the last say. You, God, you have the last say. So God, we will not see his tricks that he's putting all these aches and pain on us. We will trust in you. We believe your report. We shall believe the report of the Lord. And God, when we do the natural, you will do the supernatural. So we place it all in your hands this morning, Lord. We pray for our justice system in our country. Lord, these people who are in charge, many times, Lord, they don't deal fairly. But you are a fair God and you are a just God. And you are going to stop all these things that are going on in our country. You are going to stop them. We place the system in your hands that whether you are rich or you are poor, justice will prevail in Jamaica the right way, Lord. So we ask that you will direct our leaders, our government, the police force, Lord, you will direct them the right way. That God, they will not be biased, but God, they will deal fairly with people in our country and other country. We pray for Sister Taylor for a total. We pray for Sister Taylor. We pray for Sister Taylor for a total turnaround in her life. Lord, help her to give it to you and to realize that she's a child of the King. And God, you will turn her around.
Lord,
help her to exercise her faith in you, Lord. Help us not to pray and doubt. Many times we go, we pray and we doubt. I wonder if this is going to happen. I wonder if this is going to happen. Lord, we leave it at the foot of the cross. When we pray, God help us not to pray with doubt, because we know the God we serve. Amen. You are the God of yesterday, today, and forever. You are still a miracle working God. You are still in the healing business. Lord, we give it to you today. Oh God, we turn it around to you today, Lord. When the enemy throw it at us, we give it to you, Jesus. Completely, we give it to you, Lord. Give her a turnaround in her life, Lord. Help her to believe in you, to pray and trust you. For you can do more than we can ever ask or imagine. Oh, Lord, take over this morning. We know you are here with us, Lord. We know you are here. We feel your presence. We ask this morning for a special anointing from the Holy Spirit today, Lord, that whatever we ask, we believe. Thank you for today. Those who are going to work, go with them, Lord. Fire the traps of the enemy this morning and help your people to walk freely in the name of Jesus. No pain, no aches, because healing already take place. Restoration already take place, Lord. Thank you for this morning. Thank you for all you will do and continue to do in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Thank you,
amen.
Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Lord. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Amen.
There's a song that goes like this. I won't move until you bless me. I am staying right here till I hear from you. My soul is thirsty and I am broken. Only you can make me whole again. Only God can make us whole again. But this time I want to thank Sister Edgar for opening us with prayer this morning, and the scripture read by Sister Darcia Grant. I want to thank him very much, and the navigator, Bishop King, and the Sister Fogo Jones, who pray the intercessory prayer. May God continue to bless these people, cover them under your blood, and they continue to do the will of God. For God have us for a purpose, and we need to hold on to him and change in hand. So I ask God that he may strengthen all of us, those that are on this platform, the Remnant Corps. We want to thank them. We thank them, Brother Paul King, Reverend Martica Mullin, Reverend Mark Mullin, Pastor Philip Apollonia, Pastor Apostle Delroy Simit, Amen. Pastor Carlett, Pastor Masado and Elder Cohen. We want to thank you and all the Remnant Corps. And I'm going to turn over now to Pastor Mark Mullins.
Bless the Lord at all times. And his praise shall continually be in my mouth. God is a good God, worthy to receive all praise from the rising of the sun until the setting of the same. We do well to continue to praise him, for he alone is worthy to receive that praise that we bring. And as the praises go up, the windows and doors of heaven are opened, and his blessings are poured down and fill our waiting or longing souls. I am thankful for this opportunity that we can come together in the wake up for the word each and every morning. And we look forward to the blessings that he continues to pour out on us each and every morning. Can you imagine? Since we started this journey, we took one little break and we are here. And every morning we are being blessed. This has been a rich time. It has been a wonderful journey that we have embarked on. And I want to encourage each and every one of us to continue on the journey. For God is a good God. Come on, somebody. God is a good God. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
So we want to keep ourselves abreast of the different things that are happening. And so for tomorrow, now on screen, this is our proposed schedule for tomorrow morning. You know, we had some difficulties yesterday, so we've not been able yet to produce the recording, but they know that our internet service is back up, at least for now. We should be able to produce that sometime today, God willing. But for tomorrow morning's schedule, we are seeing it on screen. We're asking Reverend Dr. Mullins to moderate tomorrow's service, and for Sister Taylor, Sister C. Taylor, to go ahead and open up in prayer for us tomorrow. Sister Jackie Mills to do the reading, which will be from Isaiah chapter 31, verses 1 to 9. And the navigator will be Evangelist Denise Denial Gilvey, who will take us through that portion of scripture. And the intercessory prayer, we're leaning on Pastor Sandra Mills. Pastor Sandra Mills to go ahead and to do the intercessory prayer. And then we're asking Sister Daphne Hay, Sister Daphne Hay, to go ahead and to lead us out in prayer on conclusion tomorrow. So that's our potential lineup for tomorrow. If there are any challenges, as usual, you can always reach out to me. My number is in the chat, or you can connect with Pastor Paul King, whose number I'm sure he'll post momentarily also. The links remain the same. Once you type in Wake Up for the Word in YouTube, you'll get there. All the recorded services that have been uploaded are there. You can always get there. And once you do any of those services that you're on, please don't be afraid to like, share, and subscribe to the channel, and also leave a comment. These are times when, you know, once we do that, then the link that we are on, we share that among our contacts as well. And then you can always copy the link and pass it on in your WhatsApp contacts, your Instagram, whatever social media platforms you're on. We want to get this word out there so that persons can come and enjoy the rich blessings that we so enjoy on this platform each and every morning. So indeed, I look forward to seeing you tomorrow morning when we wake up for the word.
For the word.
Filled with spiritual food for life's journey. And as we say, the journey continues in life. You will now see the on screen the navigators for the coming days. We continue to add to the bottom of that list. So that's our projected navigators for the coming days. Whatever changes that will be made, you'll be advised accordingly. But this is how it is for now. Please pray for these navigators as they prepare to come online and to share the word as the Lord has laid on their heart. You will notice we have some newcomers, new kids on the block, if I can use that term, but they are not new to ministry. They are very much rich in ministry and very experienced in ministry. We look forward to hearing from each and every one of these navigators when they do join us. But for now, I will now hand over. We want to say thanks to Sister Vinette Hilton for so ably leading us through this morning as she moderated. And thank you, Sister Judith Henry, in advance for closing out in prayer for us. Didn't get the chance to share your testimony today, but we'll certainly give you the opportunity at the soonest opportunity for you to share that testimony. I'm looking forward to hearing your testimony, Sister Judith. And so at this time, I will now hand over back to the moderator. But for now, I look forward to seeing you tomorrow morning when we
wake up for the Lord
to be filled with spiritual food for life's journey. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Good morning. I'm going to ask Sister Judith Henry to please to close off us with prayer.
My testimony. Lord, we just bless you and we just honor you and we just lift up your name. Lord, we give you glory. Lord, we magnify your name. Lord, we thank you for this morning. Lord, we thank you for all that has been said, all that has been done on this platform. Lord, to you belong all glory, all honor, and all praise. God, as we are going, we pray that you will go with us for each and everyone comprehensively under your blood, Lord. And if it's your will that we should come again, Lord, let us come rejoicing. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Please, I can welcome each one. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone. God bless you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good
morning.
Good
morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
God bless you, sir. God bless you.
Good morning.
Good morning. Awesome morning.
God bless you.
Good morning to the saints of God.
Good morning, everyone. God bless you.
God bless you. Good morning, Reverend King. Good morning, Apostle Smith.
Praise the name of
God. Good morning, everyone.
Dr. Mullins. Good morning. Reverend Mullins. Good morning.
Thank you. Thank you.
The Lord bless you. Good
morning.
Pastor Masada, good morning. Good morning.
Good morning to you, Sister
Philippa. Good morning.
Sister Gordon, Sister Edgar, the Lord bless you. Sister Wallace.
Good morning, everyone.
Have a blessed day. Have a blessed day.
Thank you, the Lord.
Bless you, Karen.
Morning. Yeah. The other thing is that
Bernard,
you think I could switch back to the morning instead?
Mr. Wallace, the Lord is strengthening you.
Good morning.
Yeah, because I might have a commit. They just, you know, have something to do, but I'll be back in the evening. Please. All right, great, sir. So that would be what chapter? All right, sir. So what chapter would that be?
35. And you alone deserve my praise. You alone deserve the honor, Lord. So we lift your name high. your name high.
Yes, you do.
You alone deserve my praise.
Come on.
And you alone deserve all the honor.
Come on.
So we lift you high. Yahweh. Yeshua HaMashiach. Yeshua HaMashiach.
Yahweh, Yahweh.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeshua HaMashiach.
Yahweh, Yahweh.
My God, my God. Yeah. You are Yeshua HaMashiach.
Yahweh, Yahweh.
Yeshua. Jesus, this power in the name.